What up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasr from IT Geometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. And today, I'm on a flight back to Los Angeles, and I wanted to do something I wanted to do for a long time. Work with Instagram while it's offline and see how cool the user experience that have been developed by those guys, really. So I'm actually amazed by these little things that improve the user experience from a user point of view, and we don't really notice that much. So let's get to this, right? So I'm gonna play this video now, and the first thing here in a few seconds, I'm going to perform a like. Right, so I'm gonna like this picture. Obviously, there's no internet connection, but see what happens here is like, let me pause the video, and I like that picture immediately. That heart icon changed, and the likes count also changed. So this indicates that. Obviously, there's no way that this like actually persisted on the server, right? Because what's happening here is, for the sake of better user experience, what Instagram is doing is, it's first showing the user that, hey, I am gonna register your like as if it's gonna succeed anyway, right? Because it has to do something at the back end, right? It has to send a REST request to the services that is responsible for the likes, and then perform that like, right? Whether registering that, adding more data, right? Adding a new record to a table, whatever that is, right? It needs to take some latency, but they are absorbing that latency by showing you something at the user experience. So this is kind of false advertisement here, if you think about it, because at the time you like this picture, this actually did not like. It just queued up your request. And there is a chance that your like won't get registered, but guess what? They don't really care, because it's like, this is not a financial transaction, right? So it's like, okay, if your like does not succeed, I built this application to give you the best user experience, right? It's okay if you're like, did not register at the server. Oh, we're getting some turbulence here. All right, so it's okay if you're like, did not register. So let's see what happens here after a few seconds. After a few seconds, since I don't have internet connection, that will undo, so that operation got undone, and I'm back to 2847 likes, right? So that tells me there is some sort of a queue or a stack at the client side registered here. God damn, man, that turbulence, man. Ooh, heavy turbulence, man. All right, so yeah, that tells me there is a some sort of a stack at the client side memory. And the beauty of this, like, I am seeing this picture right now, this samurai, right? And I was able to see that picture because I was browsing Instagram while I had internet connection and just disconnected. So all of this is now cached in the Instagram memory. And guess what? When I closed and reopened Instagram, I was able to see all that stuff. So let's go ahead and play the rest of the video. What I'm about to do now here next is see the view all comments, four comments. What we know that there are four comments at the time of querying that pictures, there were four comments. But for I would think for performance reasons, those comments did not actually get retrieved, right? Same thing with the likes. This is just a count. Those, I bet if you click on those likes, nothing happens, because it needs to query and view all these comments and view all these likes, right? So let's go ahead and click on this view all four comments, which will I get? This will any second now makes a request to the service to retrieve the number of computers. There you go, right? So I'm clicking here and I'm viewing all these comments, the four comments. Attempting to view the four comments that this picture has. But look at that, right? Nothing happens going back, right? So you would think, like, why Instagram is doing that? Why is not actually showing all these or retrieving that comment at the time of querying that picture? Obviously, if you think about it, it's all about trade-off, right? So you might want to pull all these comments, but what if there are like thousands of comments, right? That the payload coming back from server will be really big, and you don't want that because again, poor user experience. So let's go ahead, and what I'm gonna do next is here I'm trying to retrieve the feed that I have here, but obviously there's nothing. So look at that. So, and I'm getting a message, no internet connection. Let's continue playing that. What I'm gonna do here is, like, I'm gonna click on the picture and the menu, and I'll attempt to use one of these stuff, right? Share to Messenger. So obviously Instagram is owned by Facebook, so obviously there will be some sort of integration between Facebook and Instagram. So I'm gonna click on copy link, and I'm assuming this will succeed because the link is a cheap, non-expensive pieces of information that it will get back as a result of retrieving these pictures. So copying the link to the clipboard does not require us to query the service, right? So it's and as we expected, it's actually succeeded. That's good. So what else, man? I'm viewing the Instagram profile for the Samurai Ward. That might actually work, depend on at the time of querying these pictures. Did we retrieve some of the profile pictures and the stories for that account or not? And it looks like we did not. So, or maybe we did, but that cache got written off by others, by other content. So there is something called the least recently used cache algorithm, where if a certain cache is not used for a certain amount of time, it will be overwritten by newer content. And this is what happens, I think, here. Going back again, we get the no internet connection. It's actually very cool that I'm still working with the application. The application doesn't hang, doesn't crash. Look at that. I'm trying to view. Now I think in a while I go upstairs. I'll go up my feed and try to view another account, right, previously up there. So I'm trying, here I'm trying to re-like this picture, and you see, as you can see, that like failed. This is another picture that has been previously cached. That's another, see, there's like one picture, or I think two videos, really. And those videos are for, I think it's only the first frame has been loaded, and the actual video was not queried. Let's see what we're gonna do here. Yeah, that's exactly what I suspected, right? It's only videos. The video, yeah, this is actually interesting. See what I did here? The comment, the original comment for that user, for that picture, was loaded, but it was not shown. It was actually truncated, but it was cached on the Instagram memory. So when I clicked on view the whole comment, I wish I can go back, but yeah, maybe I can't. But yeah, when I click on that video, nothing really happened. When I click on that comment, it will show all that video, right? It's actually interesting. View all the comment, and we don't need to query the REST endpoint to view the rest of the comments. That is so cool, man. Yep, nothing here. I think we're ending this video round. Yeah, that is really cool. It's actually amazing how the user experience. Look at that. I'm liking this. 467. After a few seconds, like 1, 2, 3 seconds, and that we don't even get an error, right? That tells me that Instagram is purposefully hiding those errors for better user experience. So if your like failed, you'll never know. If you like the picture, you'll never know that you actually like that like persisted or not. See, you're liking it again and failed, but it fails silently. Look at that. It just fails silently. That is amazing, man. Look at that. I think this is the end of the video. Yep. Yep. That's it. Yeah. So, guys, this was like a quick react on an Instagram working offline. I'm going to save this video. I'm going to upload it for you guys somewhere maybe this Wednesday, I think. All right, guys, you guys stay awesome. Hope you like this content. Let me know if you like this kind of content. I'm going to make more content like this. If you really enjoy it, we're going to make more content like this. And I like to just view this and just talk about how the user experience works versus the back end versus decisions that the developer makes to make a trade-off between the better user experiences versus load and performance. All right, guys, you guys stay awesome. Gonna see you on the next one. Good. Take care.